Getting sharp focus is a critical and sometimes frustrating part of astrophotography. Even when all your equipment is set up perfectly and it's cool to the outdoor temperatures, sometimes your focus can look and feel slightly off to the naked eye. Thankfully, there's a product out there that takes the guesswork out of focusing, and it's called a Bahtinov mask. This miracle product that almost feels like it should have its own infomercial was designed by Pavel Bahtinov back in 2005, and it uses a simple yet powerful design to help you perfect your focusing while imaging the nighttime sky. In today's video, we're going to take a look at how you can set up and use this incredible product to improve your images in astrophotography. If you enjoy this video, please like it and subscribe to this channel. But most importantly, let me know about your questions and experiences with the Bahtinov mask in the comments section below. Now let's get started by talking about how you can easily set up and use this piece of equipment to improve your images. Before buying the mask, be sure to measure the diameter of your telescope or lens that you're going to be using it for. The version that I bought cost about $12, and it's adjustable between 65 and 100 millimeters, which fits the lens hood of my Samyang lens. To get sharp focus with a Bahtinov mask, you're going to want to begin by finding a bright star, and the brighter it is, the better. Now that you've settled on the star, place the mask over the aperture of your telescope or lens. Once the mask is properly positioned on your equipment, the bright star may appear as the outline of the mask if it is greatly out of focus. As you slowly begin to adjust focus, the three grid patterns that make up the mask will slowly form into a star with three diffraction spikes shooting out of it. Sharp focus has been achieved when the middle spike is perfectly centered between the other two spikes. I found that the 10x digital zoom of my DSLR helps me to determine the positions of the diffraction spikes much easier. As you can see in these pictures I took of the focusing process, the left and right are both slightly out of focus, with the middle picture showing perfectly sharp focus. I've recently used this mask before imaging the Pleiades star cluster, and I was incredibly impressed with how sharp the image came out of the Seven Sisters and the faint blue reflection nebula surrounding it. An important thing to remember is that even once you've achieved perfect focus early on, be sure to recheck it a few times throughout your imaging session as temperatures change during the night. Also, don't forget to take the mask off before you begin imaging. I may or may not have left it on once, which led to some beautifully sharp stars with three spikes shooting through them. It was quite a unique picture, but not exactly what I was going for. If you've used or are looking to buy a Bahtinov mask, please be sure to let me know about your experience or any questions you may have in the comments section below. Thank you all so much for your continued support, and clear skies from Late Night Astronomy.